months ago. For an Eric Brand. He was living a pretty normal life. He built the house in the middle of a more heavily wooded area of Bellingham, Washington. So,
I'm here in Fairhaven area. This place, this bridge, been here a lot. Can't see me very well on this camera, but it's also just not angled very well because my fucking viewfinder is broken. Having a hard time seeing a point still. And as of yesterday, I officially can no longer afford therapy. This is all I have now. You guys. You people. Come out here. About every night now. Just to get shit out, you know. And has been working. Still taking those trips to the gateways. Well, the last two at least, since that one doesn't work anymore. I probably shouldn't be out here in the rain for much longer because the camera is probably going to break, but but there's someone coming. And it's apparent to me that I only have so much time left until eventually I'm going to become this beholder. And I can already feel it happening to me. Every little thing, I'm just turning into it more and more. It's like this thing I've always heard people talk about that I've never had, where, you know, they get a little older, they get to, maybe it's 18, maybe it's 30, maybe it's 40, 50, and they find they're starting to become their dad. I'm getting that now, but not with my dad, because I didn't fucking know him. And I'm not the one putting on a mask, grabbing a knife, going around killing people. For some reason. I'm only getting that with one of the least related people to me, biologically speaking. For some reason, I gotta take this over. And I don't think there's therapy for that. You know, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think there's a rehabilitation center for Beholders Anonymous. That seems a little far-fetched to me. I'm trying to stay off the shit. It's not easy. It just gets harder and harder and harder. You know? It just won't stop getting more and more difficult. I've just had enough of it. You know? I have had enough. Being sick every day. I'm trying to feel better. I spend the days just trying so hard. And the thing about me is everything else is checking out. It's just the shit that's making me feel bad. That's all there is to it. Everything else is fine. I eat fine. I work out fine. I wish I slept fine. It's getting better. I shouldn't complain. It's getting a little better. I used to be getting like 2 to 4 hours every night back in the day. When all this started, I'm getting like 6 now. Yeah, I might still be tired constantly, but it's astronomical for me by my standards. Squat down for a bit and talk to you guys. Something just rattled in my camera. That's weird. Pretty funky, if I do say so myself. I got a job. I deliver the paper every night. Every morning, rather. This is my day off. Wanted to see the world a bit. That's the world. That is the world I'm seeing. 35-mile-an-hour old Fairhaven Parkway. Ooh, camera. Lights, camera, action, except excluding the action to put the fucking hand strap on my hand. The rain stops, probably get out from under this tree. That's why I'm here, because water gathering up on camera, and I don't have a place to store it, so. Trying to write more music, too. In fact, when I do write music, it's the only thing that's keeping me sane. Because oftentimes, I turn to it when the world is against me. Oftentimes, it also goes along with the trips, so. Well, you know what they say about musicians. Maybe I'll release it. Maybe I'll finish it. Maybe I'll make a whole fucking record. Maybe James Okren will finally be a musician after all these fucking years of wanting it. And maybe, oh maybe, I will achieve what I wished to all that time ago. Perhaps. Perhaps if the stars align the way I want them to, then it shall happen. One day. If the label is kind enough to bring a beholder into the scheme of things, why not? Rain's getting worse, I think. I don't think this tree is going to protect me from the water much longer. Every day. I miss both of them more. Paul and the man that I never met. Can't tell which one hurts more. One of them I met vividly, the other one was my fucking dad. So. I don't know. I wish I could say I was trying to forget. Because then I probably would forget. No. No such luck. No such luck. Not on my end of things. And you know, I can still feel him around here somewhere. I think that fucking weasel is here somewhere. Perhaps I will get the chance to put it in his fucking throat. I've inherited a lot of things from my dad since I told my mom that I found the tapes. She decided it was time to, let me into his safe of things that he had left. The tape recorder. The same one that he used to make those tapes. Oh, I fucking hate that train. Freaks me out every time I fucking hear it. That shit would keep me up at night. Ah, fuck! I just got water in my eye. Went into my glasses. I can't stay here for much longer, though. I was a kid. One of the houses that I lived at, because we moved a lot. A lot. And that's why I didn't grow up in the household that had the shed. But one of them, I lived over by the water, and it's right over the railroad. And that fucking train, I had this poster in my room, this Exorcist poster. And it was like the girl, and she's all like mangled up and shit. And that train would go by every night, and I swear, in my little brain, I thought that thing was moving because I was so scared of it, you know? Those are the good days, huh? Real good days. Well, I suppose my dad was still a murderer. Back in those days. Well, not during those days, but that was still a fact back then, so I guess I shouldn't speak too much about it. You know, I felt it a bit ago, and I feel it again. He's got to be here somewhere. It feels like he's down the street. Like, it feels like he's right fucking, right down there. But he's not. I think this is how he gets to me. I think this is the way. This is his method. Sometimes he'll be there. God, I haven't seen him in months. Months. I rarely even see him in the fucking other world anymore. Well, it's even been months since I saw the Wendigo. I think the director is a fucking pussy. Because all I've seen recently is The Pursuer. No director. I'm a little otherworldly alien bitch. And I'm gonna hide from the boy who has shitty combat knife he got from his dad. which I suspect this thing was what my dad used for killing on occasion. Because he owned this thing, and he didn't own that many other weapons, so, you know, what else am I to believe, other than inheritance means significance? I'm surprised I didn't get a camera from him, considering how important those fucking things seem to be in this world of tall men and Native American folklore. I'm not even gonna go home. I just need to get some shit out, and I have so few people to talk to except for Eric these days. Danny offered, Nigel offered, but many people I have history with right now. Just about all that is Eric and you guys. Just you. I don't know how many of you there are. There's not a whole lot. I'm not some big vlogger. Not some kind of patriarch of the platform. It's not that big, but my hand will go through. Those of you who have stayed, I think those 100, 200 of you, I deeply appreciate everything that you've done for me. All of it.